How are you, Class 6 pupils? I'm Mr. Samuel again, back to our mathematics lesson. The previous lesson, we have looked into multiplication of fraction, and what we have assessed is when we are doing multiplication of fraction, the most important thing is to multiply the numerators and denominators. Multiply the numerators and the denominators. If the numbers become improper fraction, we say that you should not forget to change it into mixed fraction. In our today's lesson, we are going to look into something different on fraction, and that is we are going to look into square roots. We are going to look into square roots of fractions. Square root of fractions. We are going to look into square roots of fraction. And our first example, we are going to have 4 over 49. We find the square root. We find the square root of the 4 over 49. The first thing that we said we are supposed to do, you are supposed to find the square root of the numerator, find the square root of the numerator and the square root of the denominator, which is 49. So we realize that this one can be equal to 2 times 2 over 7 over 7. So a square root is a number that when you multiply by itself gives you the number given. Our number which is given here is 4. So we ask ourselves, which number do we multiply by itself and get 4? The number which we multiply by itself and get 4 is 2. That is why I wrote 2 here over the square root of the denominator. Our denominator is 49. You ask yourself the same question. Which number do you multiply by itself and get 49? The number which you multiply by itself and get 49 is 7. 7. So you write 7. 7 times 7 is 49. 7 times 7 is 49. 2 times 2 is 4. We only pick 1. So we are going to add 2 over 7. So our square root of 4 over 49 is going to be 2 over 7. Let's look into another example. Let us look into another example. We'll find the square root of 25 over 64. 25 over 64. So, we ask ourselves again, which number, when we multiply by itself, gives us 25? Which number, when we multiply by itself, gives us 25? And then we realize that 5 multiplied by 5, 5 multiplied by 5, gives us 25. So, the first number here, square root of 5, is going to be 5 times 5 over 64. Which number, when you multiply by itself, which number, when you multiply by itself, gives us 64? Then we realize that number is 8. 8. So, our answer is going to be simply 5 over 8. Our answer is going to be 5 over 8. Let's look into another example. Now, we are going to have a different example. Our example 3 is going to be different. Example 3 is going to be different from example 2. It is a mixed fraction. 3, 6 over 25. 3, 6 over 25. The first thing that you are supposed to do is to change the mixed fraction into improper fraction. And how do we do that? Take the denominator, multiply with the whole number, then add 6. 25 times 6 gives 25 times 3, sorry, gives us 75. 75 plus 6 will give us 81. So we are now looking for square root of 81 over 25. We ask ourselves the same question. Which number do we multiply by itself to give us 81? We realize that the number is 9. 9 times 9 is 81. So 9 times 9 over. Which number do we multiply by itself to get 25? The number is going to be 5. 5 times 5 gives us 25. So we only pick 1 and it's going to be 9 over 5. So since 9 over 5 is improper fraction, we need to change it into a mixed fraction by dividing. 5 goes to 9 once, you get 5, take away 4. So our answer is going to be 1, 4 over 5. 1, 4 over 5. Let's look into our final example, example 4. Example 4, again, is going to be a mixed fraction, whereby we have 3, 1 over 16. As we have said before in example 3, we need to change this mixed fraction into improper fraction. How? By taking the denominator, multiply with the whole number, plus the numerator. 16 by 3 gives us 48, plus 1 gives us 49. So we are going to have 49 over 16. 49 over 16. Find the square, the number that you multiply by itself to give us 49, or the square of 49. The square of 49. So square root of 49. The square root of 49. Which number do you multiply by itself to get 49? It is 7. 7 by 7. Over. Which number do you multiply by itself to get 16? It's going to be 4. 4 by 4. Therefore, our answer is going to be 7 over 4. 7 over 4. 7 over 4. Since 7 over 4 is in proper fraction, let's change it into a mixed fraction. Let us change it into a mixed fraction. 7 divided by 4. So goes 1 here, then here it goes 4, take away 3. Our final answer is going to be 1, 3 over 4. 1, 3 over 4. So that is it on working out on, that's it on working out on square roots of fraction. Sometimes you might get a number and you find that you don't know how to get the square, to get the square root. How do you do? You just need to list the factors of the number, for example, 16, and then we use the factor 3. To get square roots, you can start by dividing by 2. 16 divided by 2, we get 8. Again, we divide 8 divided by 2, we get 4. Again, we divide 4 by 2, we get 4 divided by 2, we get 2. We don't divide by that, so these are the numbers which you multiply by 7 to get 16. So 2 times 2 times 2. You take this 2, multiply by this 2, multiply by this 2, multiply by this 2. So these numbers, you need to group them. In every group, pick one. So here, we pick 2, and in this group, we pick 2. So 2 times 2 is 4. Therefore, the square root of 16 is 4. That is just a reminder on what you will learn on finding square roots. So after this, you are going to get an exercise on square roots of fractions, and I expect you to do the work and submit it into Google Classroom. So make sure you submit your work for marking to ensure that you have understood the lesson. I wish you a good day.